Hello internet, welcome back to my another video. If you're new here, I'm Revanth, and in this channel I'm making content regarding this cloud technologies, big data space and DevOps space. So if you are of that interest, consider subscribing to this channel. In this video, we're gonna talk about the 7 skills that you need to own in order to become a good and proficient cloud engineer. So I have a lot to share, so without any further delay, let's jump into the video. Skill number 1, Linux. Once you become a cloud engineer, definitely you are going to be working on Linux systems majority or 97%, because only the 3% is the Windows machines where you need to work on occasional basis. So majorly we'll be working on Linux OS or Linux systems. You must to have a good understanding on the Linux OS, the kernel and various commands to interact with the OS, and how the networking works and various layers of user groups and permissions in the file level permissions. So you need to master and have a very good understanding on the Linux OS. So that is the basic foundation to become a good cloud engineer. Skill number 2, networking. As a cloud engineer, you will be working mostly on these aspects, like establishing a network connection between 2 different components or 2 different accounts. So you'll be playing around with these networking areas. So it is must to have a good understanding on these networking concepts, such as how your DNS works, how the DHCP works, how your HTTP protocol works, and a clear understanding on OSI models. The reason why I put these 2, networking and the Linux, in the first place is anybody can become cloud engineer just by watching few tutorials, and they can easily become an AWS or Azure or GCP cloud engineers. But what makes the difference is, like, once you have this solid background or understanding of these basics, so you will definitely possess these skills in everyday task and work that you do. So eventually you'll be able to build a solid, scalable, robust, efficient, cost-effective, secure cloud infra for your company. So definitely you need to master these 2 skills and then pitch into the next 5 skills. Skill number 3 is scripting. As a cloud engineer, in your day-to-day task, you may not be writing a complete whole lot of hectic coding, but it is expected that you should be able to write scripts to do some lift and shift works or to automate some parts within the cloud infrastructure. You may be expected to write templates to automate the cloud provisioning and all. So it is great that if you can pick up scripting skills, especially in shell scripting, Python scripting and Groovy scripting, because these 3 are industry standards. So you will be working on these 3 scripting languages mostly. Either you will be writing some Linux commands and put it into your script and use it for automation. Otherwise, if you want to create some small pipelines and all, definitely you will be requiring to write some Python script. So when you go for CI/CD pipelines using Jenkins, definitely you will be using Groovy. So my recommendation is at least master any 2 of these scripting languages, and one more is good to know. Number 4, cloud service providers. Actually, this is where the debate happens, which cloud to pick up, AWS or Azure or GCP, AWS, Azure or GCP. So it is a never-ending debate. I don't want to get too much into the topic, but here is my 2 cents. If you want to learn cloud easily, pick up AWS. The reason being is AWS is far superior in the market and have a good market share. More than around 50% of the market is still under AWS. And also it is being the market leader from the long time. So it has good documentation and easy tutorials, and its certification has a very good value in the market. So the one is competition, because most of the cloud engineers pick up AWS as their core cloud service provider, and they do learn it and do certification and become available in the market. So there is a good competition for AWS compared to Azure and GCP. If you want to pick up a cloud engineer role with less competition, then go with Azure or GCP, because as of now, Azure is not far behind AWS. It is catching up and filling up the gap much more faster. So more and more companies are opting for Azure and GCP as well. So taking up that path is also not going to be in a wrong direction. And also there is be less competition. So keep that into consideration. Number 5. Virtualization and containerization. Virtualization. It is a concept of running different flavors of different applications altogether, packaged in a separate container and running it in a same underlying physical hardware, but each will be isolated as a separate container. So this concept is called as virtualization. Nowadays, most companies are opting for these virtualization techniques and using Docker and Kubernetes for productionizing their containerized applications. If you can pick up this virtualization and containerization skill, especially with Docker and Kubernetes, then definitely you can land into a very good, technically challenging cloud engineer role. So once you master these skills, then it will be a very good add-on to your resume. So eventually you'll be in much more demand in the cloud engineering space. Number 6, programming skills. I know most of you might not like this skill to be in the top 7 list to become a cloud engineer, but the fact is companies or the organizations or most job descriptions will have this programming skill as one of the required skill, because any engineer is expected to code. It may not be a full-time coding role, but your role will require you to code at times. That is true for cloud engineers as well. So if at all I need to suggest some programming languages for cloud engineers, I would suggest Python and Go as a first initial set, and Rust and Ruby can be a second set of programming languages that you can consider. I think you'll be fine with Python and Go, and you don't need to be a master in that, but it is recommended for you to learn and understand the programming languages and how to implement something and understand the best practices while writing the code. So this will be fine. Skill number 7, DevOps. I can talk one whole day on insisting why the DevOps skill is must for a cloud engineer, because most organization is not clear about what is DevOps. Most companies treat DevOps as a separate tool or a technology, but they fail to understand that DevOps is a mindset that every engineer who works in a tech team should have. So there are a set of tools that DevOps engineers use. For example, infrastructure as a code like Terraform and Kubernetes and Ansible, Jenkins for implementing the CI/CD and Git. When you become a cloud engineer, you will be expected to maintain and manage the existing cloud resources or cloud infra and provision new resources as per the requirements of different team members and access control management, and also expected to take care of these deployment activities like putting the code into production and being on call and reduce the manual efforts and automate everything. So I recommend you to pick up DevOps skills as well. So if you can learn these 7 skills and if you can master them, so definitely you are going to be in a huge demand in IT industry. It is really hard to find a skilled cloud engineer nowadays. There is huge demand, but the supply is not sufficient at this moment. So if you can pick up these skills and work on them sincerely, definitely I can bet you that you'll be landing in a good cloud engineer role with your ransom package. So hope this video helped you guys. If at all, if you feel that I missed some of the skills that is required for a cloud engineer, feel free to add them in the comment section. Definitely I will go through and I will revert back to each and every comment. And I'm also planning to make tutorial videos on cloud engineering or cloud computing area. So if you are interested, then just leave a comment in the comment section, then definitely it will be a good boost for me. Thank you so much. See you in the next video. Until then, signing off, Revanth. Bye.